What is up, Mary Bales, and welcome to a class setup. This is going to be my first one for now, and I'll do another one, and this is going to be the M4A1 class setup. So if we just go over the weapons and edit my loadout, and you'll see that I actually have overkill on. Now, we won't get to that yet. We'll actually just do the M4A1. So everyone knows, if you play Modern Warfare, or if you're somebody that is getting Modern Warfare for the Christmas, then M4A1 is the gun to use straight off the bat, and it is one of the best guns in the game, if not the best gun in the game. Now, of course, there is a lot of people saying, oh, well, you can use this gun and it's better and all that. That's personal opinion. Majority of the people, or majority of the community, will say the M4A1 is probably the best gun in the game. Now, as you can see, I actually have 5 attachments on it. Might be a bit overkill, but you know, it is what it is. So if we go straight into the gunsmith now, we'll start with muzzle. So on the muzzle, I have the compensator. Now, of course, the pro is this is the recoil control. So this actually controls your recoil when you're shooting people. However, the aim down sight speed and aim and stability is a con. Basically is reduced, although you don't really feel it, to be honest, because your accuracy goes up, and if you're kind of already aiming down sight, you'll fairly snap onto people fairly quickly. And the aim down sight speed, yeah, you don't really feel it, to be honest. You really don't feel it. Now the next, we'll head to barrel. Now there was a number of barrels that I used to use the custom marksman as well as the commando one. But the stock M16 Grenader seems like it's the best one for me personally, because it's just longer. And of course, the pros of this is the damage range is increased, the bullet velocity is increased, and the recoil control is increased. Now, of course, yet again, aim down sight speed is reduced and movement speed is reduced. But this is okay on a weapon that's an AR, basically, because you're not going to be running around the map too much with this. Now, of course, granted, you will be running around the map to get to spots, so, like, not hard point spots, but choke points, basically. Like, say, Shoe House 24/7, the game mode, the map Shoe House. There's a part called Scrapyard or Junkyard, whatever you want to call it. You can actually get up onto the cars and you can look past the tires to your left or your right, depending on which way you're looking. And of course, if you get up on the other car, you can look straight into the opposition's, not base, but you can near enough fully see in, and you can take people off before they even come around the corner, really. And it's more for holding down choke points, and if you have good aim, this just increases your range and your aim and everything like that, and it's very, very good personally for me. Now, I don't have a laser on it simply because they don't really do much. Like, yeah, they kind of do something, but for me, no, they don't. So reflex or optics in this game, I feel some of them are decent and then some of them are terrible. Like, the kind of default ones aren't great, and then there's some of them that just look absolutely terrible as well. Like, I'm not gonna put like a sniper scope on my gun or an night vision one. Like, why would I put a sniper scope on an assault rifle? Like, it just makes no sense. Some of these are decent, but you know, for me, I just picked the first one because it looks cleaner. Now, of course, precision sight picture is a pro, and then con, aim down sight speed. I don't understand how all of these have aim down sight speed. This is basically like, okay, well, you know, you'd be better off not using an optics, but you know, it is what it is as well. Although I feel personally it's better to use an optics. If I don't, it just looks like just rubbish. Like, that's it basically. And yeah, look, see, it's just like, no thanks. No, it's not for me. So I always have the Cronin LP945 mini reflex on it, just because for me personally it's good. Now, for stocks, I've seen a lot of people going around with no stocks or just having a default stock or whatever. And, you know, it looks okay normally, but for me, yeah, gotta have the M16 stock on it. Like, it's just, it's very, very good with it. Now, of course, the pro of it is the aim and stability, and of course, the con is your aim, walk, and movement speed is slowed down, which I don't understand how, but you know, it is what it is. And this I find is very good for keeping your aim stable if you're firing long shots. And if you have a pretty decent shot and accuracy, this just improves it dramatically, and it is really, really good. And I would highly recommend having this stock on it. Now, of course, you could go for the other stocks, but some of these stocks are more. They're more run and gun kind of things. These are more to not stay still, but to be able to move to places as well as post up. So the next we have underbarrel. Now there are a ton of underbarrels here, as you can see. Except I used the first one. For me, it's just the commando grip is just the better one out of all these. Because mainly they all have movement or aim down, sight speed reduced, or even the walk and movement, aim walk and movement, or movement speed are just all reduced. However, with the commando grip, it increases your recoil stabilization and your aim and stability. So you're adding at least two things. So if we just look, so aim and stability. And so that's two things for your aim, and then two things for your recoil, three things for your recoil. So you have three things for your recoil that's going to basically keep your recoil down. And of course, you have damage range on that one, and you don't have damage range on any of the other ones. Of course, you're always going to have pros, and of course, you're going to have cons. But for me personally, I think the cons actually weigh more than the pros do. And it's like, do I really need to put all this stuff on my gun? Like, could I not just go without attachments? Would it not be better? But you know, I'll have a video about that after, well, not after this one anyway, but I'll have it later on. So if we move on, the secondary weapon we have is the P90. Now the P90 for me is probably one of the best SMGs in the game. Now, okay, you can say the Bison is good. I don't like it. The MP7 is good. It is good. I like it. I just prefer the MP or the P90. And of course, I have five attachments on this one as well. And I actually have FlashGuard just because I just wanted it, to be honest. And you know, bullet velocity goes down, but your muzzle flash is concealed. You know, kind of a trade-off, but I'm not really sure. You don't want your aim down sight speed to be kind of messed up when you're running around the place and everything. So I have FlashGuard on just for me personally, because I like to run and gun with this gun, and it is great up close. And of course, bullet velocity just going down. If you're hitting the head, it'll go down. So you know, it's decent. Now I don't have a barrel on it. I was thinking of putting a barrel on it, but then I was like, your aim down sight speed is slowed down and your movement speed is slowed down. I don't think I want that. Really don't think I want that. So the next we have is the laser. Now I could easily put on the last two lasers if I wanted to. They actually give me more sprint to speed fire and aiming steadiness, aim walking steadiness, and aiming stability. But the laser is actually visible, and you know, I personally think that the hip fire accuracy one is good. And this one does seem a bit better, but you know, there's not really much in the difference, to be honest. You can go for this one if you want. Personally, I like the first one, but out of these two, it is better. This one, it's okay, but sprint to fire is very good. It's better than most of these. Like, you don't see sprint to fire speed going up here or here. So it's personal preference on that one. The reflex sight, again, I have picked the first one on this one, which is Solo Zero Optics Mini Reflex. Now, of course, aim down sight speed is reduced and precision sight picture is increased. This one, again, I'm going to say it, is a personal preference. You can easily have this one, the GI Mini Reflex, which looks decently good towards this one. They kind of look the same a bit. You could easily have a fucking... You could easily have this, the FSS Ring Sight, which just looks absolutely terrible to me. But, you know, personal preference, you know. I do have a perk on, but, you know, you don't really have to put a perk on. I just have this on. So, when you're shooting somebody and if they go around the corner and you start chasing them, they actually can't heal up fully for a few seconds. Like, it's just briefly delayed, so that can give you time to run around the corner and kill them easier. You know, for me personally, I like that. And the underbarrel, then I have the granulated grip tape. Now, the movement speed, yes, is decreased, and the aiming stability is increased, but look, aim, walk, and movement speed, aim down sight speed, and aim down sight speed are all reduced anyway with these two. Yeah, recoil control, aiming stability is up, but aiming stability and then movement speed is the only thing that's wrong with this, which in my mind is decent. I kind of like this. You have a load more control, and if you look at the stats, the accuracy is actually up a little bit. Damage stays the same, range stays the same, fire rate, of course, that's going to stay the same. The mobility stays the same, but your control goes up a lot. Now, in this game, your control is something that you want to look at. Your range isn't really what you want to look at, depending on what maps you're going to be playing. Accuracy is one that you want to look at as well, because you want to have a good accuracy. Mobility, it completely depends on you. If you're one of those people that have godlike internet or just laggy people that can run around the map and kill people around corners, then that's for you, you know. Just look out for all that. So, if we next go to perks. So, perks, of course, I have overkill. Now, EOD you could easily use on this and then put a pistol in for your secondary. It's completely up to you. But for me personally, having two of the best guns in your arsenal straight away is huge for me personally, and I think it is a way better idea than having EOD double time or scavenger. Now, you could put scavenger on if you wanted, but that would only be really for this one, because you can pick up their weapons anyway, and 9 times out of 10 you're going to be constantly picking up ammo anyway off dead bodies, because half the time they're going to have M4A1s. P90 doesn't come with a lot of bullets, but it's still a very, very, very good weapon. Huge clip. You get 50 bullets in it straight away. So you have that kind of to spray and pray as well. And, you know, it's a decent gun, like it was in Modern Warfare 2 and Modern Warfare 3. And it's back in this. Now, for me personally, I have Hardline. You could easily have, for people who are bad at the game, Kill Chain, or maybe even Point Man if you want it. Ghost is a lot that people usually use or restock. For me, Hardline, because I run not high kill streaks, but decent enough kill streaks that are easy to get this way. And I'll show you how I do it actually. So the next perk I have is Tune Up. Now, you could easily use Amp, but no, I don't. Or Shrapnel if you wanted to. I don't. I use Tune Up because I want to get my field upgrade 33% quicker, and it's very, very good for that. Very, very good, especially if you're getting kills. If you're getting kills the whole time, you'll be getting that bad boy like constantly on rotation. Next, I have a lethal. So the lethal I have is frag grenade. Of course, you can use C4, Semtex, proximity mine, or even a claymore that bitches mainly use. And of course I use a stun grenade, because stuns are actually better than flash grenades. Flash only blinds and deafens them. They can still move around and everything. With a stun, it actually slows down their movement and their aiming. So if they actually see you in their sights, but they're not actually looking at you, like, and you're shooting them, it'll take them that few seconds longer to try and shoot you. And this actually gives you more time to kill them. And that's personal preference as well. You can use flash, stun, or even stim if you wanted. Loads of people I've seen have been using this, and you know, it's decent, but I prefer a stun because you can throw out that stun, go around the corner, kill two people, or stun a bunch of people before they come and then chuck out a nade and blow them up, or blow one or two of them up, or whatever, or even slow down the enemy. And yeah, that's really my class setup for the M4A1. I know I kind of put the P90 in here as well, but I'll have a P90 class setup after this one. And yeah, that is it, guys. Hope you like, favorite, and subscribe. And yeah, this is the end of the video. I know I keep getting my intros mixed up, but still, you know what it is? It is what it is. So if you want to check out my live stream, which I'll probably be live streaming either by the time you see this or a while after, depending, I'm not really sure. But I'll be live on Twitch. Link to that will be in the description below. I also live stream sometimes on Mixer as well. Link to that will be in the description below. And I have a Twitter where I manually update it or just give my opinions or tweet out whenever I go live. And link to that will be in the description below. And of course, if you are ever on Twitch or Twitter or even Mixer right now and you just have it open in another tab, just type in Lord_Originals, just like my YouTube, and it'll come up with me, and you can follow me and stay up to date whenever I go live. But yeah, that's it, guys. Hope you like, favorite, and subscribe, and peace.